Welcome back, let's learn about tables. Tables are another data type, just like strings, numbers, and booleans. They work just like a table like this, and can hold any amount of data at once. To create an empty table, we use two curly brackets and can then assign it to a variable. To add a value to our table, we reference our table and then type an index value in square brackets. The index is similar to a variable name, but can be any data type as well as variables referring to the data. We then assign the index to a value of any data type with the assignment operator. And congratulations, our table now contains a piece of information. Similar to variables, we can get the value by referencing the table's name and then the index in square brackets. If the index is a string that meets the requirements for a variable name, you can also assign and reference values like this. This is syntax sugar, which means that these work exactly the same, but this is designed to be easier to read. For example, the wait function mentioned previously is in the built-in task table, so it can also be called like this. When declaring a table, you can also enter values directly like this. Because new lines are ignored in Lua, this can be formatted into a single line or like this if there's a lot of information. Values are separated by commas, and string indexes can also be formatted like this for easier readability. We can also create tables where we don't specify the indexes at all, like this. By default, these values are automatically given indexes starting from 1 and go up by 1 for each value. We can assign and reference these values as expected. As you might expect, we can even set tables as values within tables. For example, this variable has a table containing players where each player has their own table of items. We can then reference these items like this, which is the same as you would for individual tables. For tables formatted as a list, we can use this operator to get the length of the table. We can then use it to iterate through each value with a for loop, like this. To iterate through every value in a more complex table, we can use a generic for loop. For this, we declare two variables, one for the index and one for the value. We then type in alongside the table or a reference to the table. The for loop will now iterate for each value in our table, with our two variables being updated on each loop. This works with tables created as a list and tables created as a dictionary, as they are fundamentally the same. We can also embed these for loops when dealing with tables that look like this. Now, be sure to practice and then move on to functions when you're ready.